In this video, we'll be discussing what factors affect your transfer speeds when you use the Android version of Zapia, and what you can do to improve your transfer speeds. Please keep in mind when watching this video that there are other factors, but we will only be covering the ones that play the largest roles in determining how fast you can create a connection and share files. Now let's dive in. Your transfer speeds are directly related to what version of Zapia you have, what version of Android operating system your device has, whether your device supports 5 GHz, and what device you're connecting to. You can look at the time cones in the corner of the screen and in the description to skip ahead to the part of the video that interests you the most. However, we recommend you watch the entire video since all four factors are directly related to each other. Your transfer speeds might be slower than usual if you're using an older version of Zapia. We continually update Zapia so that you can enjoy the best user experience possible. If you have not already, we highly recommend you upgrade to the latest version of Zapia. You can check if you have the latest version by clicking on the Me icon at the bottom of your screen and then clicking on the Settings icon on the top right corner of the screen. After that, select More Settings and click on Check for Updates. The system will notify you if you have the latest version or if you need to update your app. The default connection settings for Zapia differ depending on what version of Android operating system your device has installed on it. You can check what version of Android operating system you have on your device by going to your device's settings and clicking on About Phone. Depending on what year your device was made, it may not be able to update to the latest version of Android. This will not affect your ability to use Zapia. Zapia automatically selects the connection mode that ensures the fastest connection speed according to what version of Android operating system your device has. As you can see in this table, every version of the Android operating system has different requirements when it comes to creating a connection using Wi-Fi hotspots and Wi-Fi Direct. On devices that have Android 10 or 11 installed, users can bypass the input of a password when the device they are transferring to also supports Wi-Fi Direct. If you're experiencing issues with creating a connection, try changing the mode from automatic to the suggested default mode for the version of Android operating system you have. You can do this by clicking on the transfer icon located at the bottom of your screen and then clicking on Connection Settings. Under Settings for Create Group, select Wi-Fi Hotspot or Wi-Fi Direct according to which version of Android operating system you have. Another reason why you might be experiencing slower connection speeds is because your device does not support 5 GHz. No matter what version of Android operating system your device has, the default channel on Zapia is set to prioritize trying to use 5 GHz to establish a connection before the other wireless frequencies. If your device does not support 5 GHz, then it will take a bit longer to create a connection using this channel. If you have an older or lower end device, it may not support 5 GHz. You can check if your device supports 5 GHz by checking your device's specs online or using a Wi-Fi Analyzer application. If you choose to use a Wi-Fi Analyzer application to check, you will also be able to find a less crowded channel for your wireless router. It is important that you use a channel that is not crowded when you're transferring files. When there are too many devices using the same channel at the same time, it will slow down the connection. On devices that do not support 5 GHz, we recommend changing the connection settings from the default to prioritizing compatibility over speed. To do this, click on the transfer icon located at the bottom of your screen and then click on the connection settings icon. Under Settings for Create Group, you will need to first change the mode to either Wi-Fi Hotspot or Wi-Fi Direct to change the channel from high speed to compatibility. Please refer to the table shown earlier in this video when selecting whether to set the mode to either Wi-Fi Hotspot or Wi-Fi Direct. How fast your device connects and transfers data depends heavily on the compatibility of the devices. If there's an issue with compatibility, transfer speeds can be slow and there's a possibility that the connection will fail. To ensure that the devices are compatible, make sure that both devices are using the latest version of Zapia. Another way to ensure the devices are compatible is by selecting Wi-Fi Hotspot as the channel for Create Group. Not all devices support Wi-Fi Direct, so Wi-Fi Hotspot is the safer choice when it comes to creating a connection. You can change the mode by opening the Connection Settings menu by clicking on its icon on the transfer screen and selecting Wi-Fi Hotspot under the mode header. Devices that do not support 5 GHz will not be able to scan and find devices that are operating on a 5 GHz wireless frequency. This problem can easily be fixed by the device that is creating the group by changing their connection settings. The device that is creating the group just needs to click on the transfer icon located at the bottom of the screen and then click on the connection settings icon. Under Settings for Create Group, you will need to first change the mode to either Wi-Fi Hotspot or Wi-Fi Direct in order to change the channel from high speed to compatibility. Please refer to the table shown early in the video when selecting whether to set the mode to either Wi-Fi Hotspot or Wi-Fi Direct. As you can see, your transfer speeds are determined by a number of factors. We have optimized Zapia so you can transfer files of any format and of any size to any platform, and by doing so, some of the default settings may not be the best ones for your device. You have the power to change the settings to ensure you experience the fastest transfer speeds possible. If you have any questions, feel free to ask us in the comments below or send us an email at feedback@domobile.net. Thanks for watching!